And welcome back. It's time for my favorite part of Monday on Ozarks Live. Turn back time. That is not easy to say.
If I could turn back time.
I accept your praise. And away we go. January 27, 1984, Michael Jackson's hair catches fire during the filming of a Pepsi commercial.
I remember that.
Yeah, he suffered second-degree burns on his scalp and face. Oh. Pepsi settled for $1.5 million, which was donated to the Brotman Medical Center in Culver City, California, and they named the burn unit after Michael Jackson. Mm. All right. A happy birthday to Howard McNear. Born in 1905, Floyd the Barber on the Andy Griffith Show from 61 to 67. Also, Doc Adams on the radio version of Gunsmoke from 1952 to 1961. Also, happy birthday to Frank Rocky Fiegel, born in 1868. Said to be the real-life inspiration for Popeye, created by E.C. Seeger in 1929. He was said to be unusually strong, smoked a pipe, and liked to fist fight. He was from Seeger's hometown. Seeger regularly sent him money because he used him, yes. January 28, 1956, Elvis Presley makes his television debut on Tommy and Jimmy Dorsey's stage show on CBS, performing Shake, Rattle, and Roll, and I Got a Woman. His appearance generated a flood of mail from viewers who couldn't understand how they could allow someone like Elvis on the program. The ratings went up, and Elvis appeared six more times.
I bet they did.
Yes. Happy birthday to Robert Stroud, born in 1890. He was an American, a convicted killer known as the Birdman of Alcatraz. Became an expert on bird diseases while spending 44 years in solitary confinement. Burt Lancaster portrayed him in the 1962 movie. He also spent some time right here in Springfield at the FedMed.
Hmm.
Yep. Also, identical twins Jean and Auguste Piccard. Remember that name. 1884, pioneers in ballooning and diving vehicles. Along with Jean's wife, they established many records of the time, including the highest ascent into the stratosphere. They went about 11 miles up, and lowest descent into the ocean. Gene Roddenberry named Jean-Luc Piccard after them.
Nice.
All right. January 29th, 1845, The Raven by Edgar Allan Poe is first published in the New York Evening Mirror. It instantly made him famous, that poem. Mm-hmm. Happy birthday to Alan Balcom Dumont, born in 1901. He developed the first commercially practical cathode ray tube in 1931, marketed the first home TV receiver in 1939, and established the Dumont Network, which was the first licensed television network. One very popular show I'm sure all of you remember was entitled Rocky King, Inside Detective. A Private Eye series starring Roscoe Carnes.
That is incredible.
We all remember Inside Detective. Also, this is one of my favorites, William Claude Duncan Field, W.C. Fields. 1880 is when he was born. Comedian, actor, writer, an incredible juggler, if you didn't know that. You Can't Cheat an Honest Man and My Little Chickadee were only two of his films. He also said one of the better things he said, never give a sucker an even break, nor smarten up a chump. Everybody forgets the second part. January 30th, 1789. You wonder about how things go in Congress? Okay, first brawl on the floor of the U.S. House of Representatives. During an argument, Matthew Lyon of Vermont spit in the face of Roger Griswold of Connecticut. 2 weeks later, after the resolution to remove Lyons failed, Griswold attacked Lyon with his cane. Lyon retreated to a fire pit and defended himself with the fire tongs until other congressmen broke up the fight.
I don't think we're doing much better these days.
No, but when you think things get rowdy in Congress, look at what happened.
Yeah.
All right, a happy birthday to Douglas Engelbart. 1925. Everybody say thank you to him. He is the American computer scientist and inventor of the computer mouse. in 1967. You can see his model there. Also, a happy birthday to Frank Gillette Burgess, 1866. He was an American author, humorist, and illustrator. He wrote the famous quatrain, "I never saw a purple cow, I never hope to see one, but I can tell you anyhow, I'd rather see than be one." He also coined the word blurb to describe the material on a book jacket that praises the book. January 31st, 1989, Mrs. Maria Oliveira of San Juan, Argentina, gives birth to her 32nd child.
No.
She had a triplet and two sets of twins and that whole thing. Also, happy birthday to Jackie Robinson, 1919. American Hall of Fame baseball player, 1949 most valuable player, first black player in the major leagues with the 47 Brooklyn Dodgers, and first black player inducted into the Baseball Hall of Fame in 1962. Also, a happy birthday to Zane Grey, born in 1872. American Western novelist, his novels have been adapted into over 100 films.
Wow.
He was also a minor league baseball player. He played one game with the Pittsburgh Pirates in 1903. His novel, Riders of the Purple Sage, sold over 12 million copies. All right, finally this. What is the most popular item sold at Walmart? I'll give you a hint. They sell more than any other single item they have in stock.
Gum.
Good guess. Bananas.
Bananas.
That's it. My work
I bought
here
some
is
yesterday.
Done. So that wraps it up for this edition of Turtin' Back Time.
If I could turn.